Middle ear. Between. Application program. And hardware. The next pause. It's an interface between. As a system, it is resource allocator. So the first from TCP generation. TCP is the processor for clock. By this process scheduling. Fourth is process synchronization. Fifth is inter-process communication. And the last is process termination. To understand the complete functionality of this process management, firstly, you have to know about the steps of process management and the stages or life cycle of the process. So, to introduce the life cycle of process, first model developed as five stage diagram. In this diagram, the process has been five stages in a life cycle. First stage was new, second was ready, third is running, fourth is exit or termination state, and the fifth is waiting state. Now, first understanding functionality. The processes came from the job pool, that is in the disk, to the bank. It is in new state means the process is just newly created or came into the memory, then come to the register bank and is ready. It is also in RAM. Next stage is the running. It is also in the non-stop interrupt operation bank. It comes to the register that is also in RAM. When the interrupt operation is completed, again come to the register, then running. When it completes this process, it comes to the exit. But the problem with this five-stage diagram is that all the four stages of the process was in RAM. So the problem was the limitation of RAM size. Because we are dealing with thousands of processes at a time, and all are inherent in either new state, ready state, running state, or waiting state, all other states in the RAM. So the limitation of RAM size was the major problem with this five state diagram. So to remove this problem, we introduce the second, that is sixth state diagram. In this diagram, only the next state is introduced for the block state. This state is in this. When the RAM is full, from waiting, and the RAM is full, we move the process from waiting state to block state. And when RAM is free, we move it towards the ready state, either or waiting state. So the problem of this RAM full is removed by introducing this particular state, that is block state. Now compare this diagram with these processes. First is the process creation, means we are fetching the process from the job pool to new state. Means the process just came into the RAM. This is the process creation that may be created by the user, hardware, or operating system. Anyone that can use or can create a process. The second is the PCB generation. Process control block is a block which has all the information about the process. Like a newborn baby. When the baby is just born, it is in new state. When we are talking about some information about the baby, like the father, mother, the date of birth, the date of time, all the information, that is the PCB generation of this process. So, PCB holds the process ID, process name, the owner, permissions, number of files it has, number of open files, state, and all the information regarding the process. So now we are in the middle stage between the new and ready. After this receive generation, we are came to the ready state. Means now we are here. Now the next is the process scheduling. Coming from the ready to the ready state, we have to schedule the process. Scheduling means assigning a particular sequence with respect to the time of the process to be executed. So the next is the process scheduling. Next is HRR. basic 8 algorithms used by the computer, and these 2 algorithms were completely introduced by the gate problem for me. So one by one we will take the processes or giving. So the first is the first one was in this type of scheduling, the process A first will be served first for the execution in the CPU. The criteria of this algorithm is arrival time, means the process arrive first will serve first, and the mode is non-printing mode. Means no one will interrupt the algorithm in a bit. Now take an example and we will explain the complete processing of this FCFS. This is the processing 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Arrival time are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. First time is 4, 3, 1, 2, 5. So the rule says the process A first will serve first. We draw a Gantt chart to represent the sequencing of the processes. Starts with a time quarter 0. At 0, P1 only becomes. So the process P1 will execute first as 4 times, up to 4. In between 1, 2, 3, 4 is P2, P3, P4 and P5 came. And P2 came at 1, P2, P3 came at 2, P4 came at 3, P5 came at 4. All the processes came when the P1 is running only. So the sequence will be the same after that P2, then P3, then P4, then P5. And execution time will be for P2, 3, so the year 7, 1, year 8, 2, year 10, and 4, 5, year 15. Now the time to calculate turnaround time and waiting time. Turnaround time is the time difference between the completion time and arrival time, and waiting time is the difference between turnaround time and cluster. So, firstly we have to calculate turnaround. So, the completion time of P1 is 4, arrival is 0, so turnaround will be 4, P2 completion is 7, arrival is 1, turnaround will be 6, P3 completion at 8, arrival at 2, turnaround will be 6, P4 completion is 10, arrival is 3, turnaround will be 7, P5 completion at 15, arrival at 11, will be 11. Waiting time differs between turnaround and burst. 4 minus 4 is 0, 6 minus 3 is 3, 6 minus 1 is 5, 7 minus 2 is 5, and 11 minus 5 is 6. Now we have to calculate the average value of turnaround time and average value of waiting time. Average amount would be 4 plus 6 plus 6 plus 7 plus 11 divided by 5, and waiting time will be 0 plus 3 plus 5 plus 5 plus 6 divided by 5. So the calculation will be 34/5 and 19/5 is equals to 6.8 nanoseconds and 3.8 nanoseconds. Once again explain this, we have to firstly generate the Gantt chart. To produce the Gantt chart at 0 P1 only came, so we have to process the P1 first up to 4, so 0 to 4. In between P2, P3, P4 and P5 all came, the sequence will be same as the arrival time. P2, P3, P4 and P5, the execution time will be 3, 1, 2, 5. So from 4 to 7, 7 to completion of P2 is 7 and either at 1, so difference is 6. Completion of P3 is 8 and either at 2, difference is 6. Completion of P4 is 10 and either at 3, difference is 7. Completion of P5 is 15 and either at 4, difference is 11. Waiting time is the difference between turnaround and bus time. So this is the turnaround and this is bus. 4 minus 4 is equal to 0, 6 minus 3 is equal to 3, 6 minus 1 is equal to 5, 7 minus 2 is equal to 5, and 11 minus 9 is equal to 6. For average calculation, we have to add all these and divide by the 5 by the 3 of the 500 processes. Stay in this waiting time, add all the waiting time respectively, divide by the 5. So here, the complete answer as 6.8 milliseconds for the average turnaround and 3.8 for the average waiting time. Now, take the next question and see the magic of this FCMS method. Now we have three processes as P1, P2, and P3. Arrival time of all three is 0 and burst time of P1 is 27 nanoseconds, P2 is 3 nanoseconds, and P3 is again 3 nanoseconds. We have to calculate the average turnaround time and average waiting time. Firstly, we draw the Gantt chart. All the three came at 0, P1, P2, and P3 at 0. First, P1 will process up to 27, then P2 up to 30, and P3 up to 32, because the burst time of P2 is 3 and P3 is also 3. Now, the turnaround time and waiting time calculation for P1 turnaround time is 27, completion at 27 came at 0. For P2 completion at 30 came at 0. For P3 completion at 33 came at 0. Waiting time is turnaround minus burst time, that is 27 minus 27, that is 0. 30 minus 3, 27, and 33 minus 3, 30. Now average calculation. Turnaround time average will be 27 plus 30 plus 33 divided by 3, that is 90 by 3, 30 and average waiting time is equals to 0 plus 27 plus 30 divided by 3, that is 57 by 3 is 9. Now, see the magic of this FCFS. After just changing the sequence of these processes, like P1 needs 3 nanoseconds, P2 needs 3, and P3 needs 27 nanoseconds. See the Gantt chart. All the 3 keep at 0, P1, P2, and P3. Firstly, P1 will process, then P2, then P3, and the execution time will be 3 nanoseconds, 0 to 3, again 3 nanoseconds, 3 to 6, and 27 nanoseconds, 3 to 33 nanoseconds. Now, the calculation of turnaround time and waiting time. The turnaround of P1 will be 0 to 3, 3 is the completion, and 0 is the arrival, so 3. 6 is the completion, 0 is the arrival, so 6. 33 is the completion and 0 is the arrival, so 33. Waiting time will be 3 minus 3, 0, 6 minus 3, 3, 33 minus 27 will be 6. Now the calculation of average turnaround and average waiting. 3 plus 6, 9, 33, 42 by 3. And 9 by 3, that is 3 nanoseconds and 14 nanoseconds. Now see the difference here, the average turnaround is 30 nanoseconds. average turnaround and average waiting time. So if we are just changing the process execution and we get the different answers. This problem is called the convoy effect. The effect of this problem is called the convoy effect dealing with the FCSOP. So to remove this effect, introduce the second scheduling algorithm which deals with the job which is the lowest burst time, that is SJF, shortest job first scheduling. This SJF is easy to implement, easy to understand, but have the problem of the convoy effect. So we are not dealing with this FCFS generally. We use instead that SJF, that is shorter job first. Again, take an example of the shorter job first to explain it. The criteria first, here burst time is speed of the arrival time, and the mode is again non-critical mode. Now take an example. These are the processes P1, P2, P3, P4 and P5. These are the arrival time 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. First time is 7, 5, 1, 2, and 8. Now, draw the Gantt chart. Again, start from 0. No process came at 0. The first process came at 1. So, from 0 to 1, it will be at one fever came, so we have to process it. The bus time is 7 up to 8. The process even will execute. In between, P2 will came, P3, P4, and P5 at 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now we have all the processes even completed its execution. It is now in the race. We have P2, P3, P4 and P5 now. We see that which one has the shortest burst time. So P3 have. So we have to process P3 first for one quantum. Then P4 for two quantum, that is 11. Then after that, P2 for 5 up to 16, and last P5 will process up to 24. Once again, 0 to 1, no process came, so the 0 to 1 time will be CPU idle, and one fever came, so we have to process it first because no one in the race. So P1 will first execute from 1 to 8 because the burst time is 7. In between P2, P3, P4, P5 all came at 2, 3, 4 and 5 respectively. Then we have 4 processes in the race. Now we have calculated that which one is the shortest. So the P3 is shortest because the burst time is only 1. So P3 is first and 89. Then P4 came. P2 from 9 to 11, then P2 came, P2 from 11 to 16, then P5 at last came from 16 to 22. Now calculate the turnaround time. That is the completion time minus completion time of P1 is 8, arrival as 1, so turnaround is 7. Completion of P2 is at 16, arrival at 12, so turnaround will be 14. P3 completion at 9, arrival at 3, turnaround is 6. P4 completion at 11, came at 4, so turnaround 6 minus 1, 5, 7 minus 2, 5, 19 minus 8, 11. Now the average temperature. Again,